Hello and welcome to ITC TechShare. I'm Tom Grissom. Today I'd like to do a demonstration of using the Surface Pro to create your own music. To begin with, I'm on the start screen and I've already loaded the application Acoustica Mixcraft version 6, so let's begin by selecting this icon. That opens up the desktop application. You'll notice that we're on the desktop, and whenever you first start Mixcraft, it offers you a choice of three types of projects. So the first choice is record yourself or your band. This is for like a regular microphone recording to record either your voice or a musical instrument. Choice two says build loop and beat match music. And I'll do a demonstration of that here in just a second. And then what I usually choose is build virtual instrument tracks. So I'm going to choose choice number three here. And you'll notice that this main work area here, each one of these is an independent track. So the first two tracks, it says that it's an instrument track, and you'll notice the little keyboard symbol here. This is if you have a USB MIDI keyboard, like a piano style keyboard, you can plug it into the Surface Pro and it will recognize it as an instrument, and then you can begin playing freeform notes, and that's really a neat thing to be able to do. But today we're going to concentrate on the audio tracks. So to begin with, let me see if I can expand this a little bit to give you a little bit of an overview here. The bottom one third of the screen, you've got four different tabs, and I'm on the library tab right now. Why I'm thinking about it for this recording, I really need to lower the mixer level here because the music can be a little bit loud when I'm recording. But within the musical library, you will see all of these different musical genres, and they're in alphabetical order here. So you have everything from blues to synth rock to video game, to classical, classic jazz, classic rock. Just scroll on down, look at all these different choices. Groove, hip-hop, industrial, you have sound effects available, and Vegas rock, just a number of different ones. Within each one of these genres, let me just go down here and pick on one. So let's try Country Rock 2 here to begin with. Let me get back to my work area so we can see a little bit better. Now I'm using my pen because the interface is very tiny, so it requires precise movement. So either I would recommend either using a mouse, or I love the digital pen that comes with the Surface Pro. So typically we want to go out, and country music generally starts with a drum track. So let's just preview here by clicking this little green button. Okay, if that sounds like what we want, we can click, hold, and drag, and I'm using my pen here. Click, hold, and drag that track to the first audio track, and it's asking if I want to change the beats per minute. Yes, I do. Typically, a drum track will go on throughout the song, so let's expand this. I'm just click, hold, and drag. Let's go out to about 16 measures or so here, just for this demonstration. This is what I call painting music, and another benefit of having the Surface Pro because of the digital pen is very accurate in doing this. So after we do the drum track, we typically will do a bass. Okay, generally the bass starts a couple of measures after we begin the drums. So I'm going to grab again with my pen. The very end, it turns into a double-headed arrow, and then I can lengthen the number of measures that particular loop will play. And let's add one more. Let's do the acoustic guitar. So that's solo, but if we add it up to the third audio track here in this case, let's go a couple measures. That kind of gives us this stair step approach. And while we're here, let's just call that good for now. So let's go back to the very beginning, and let me back this all the way up, and let's just take a listen and see what we have so far. Okay, and it's that easy on the Surface Pro using this Mixcraft program. So earlier I had another project I was doing. I was playing around with some classic rock style music. So let me come out here and open a project that I already have available. No, I don't want to save my current one. I was just playing around there. So I have a folder called Music Project, and I saved three different versions of a classic rock type track. So let me open up version 3 here. And Let me zoom in. It's all compressed a little bit. Let me zoom in so we can see a little bit more. And let me go down to my classic rock choice. So you can see the instruments change as I go from genre to genre. And let's just go back here. The very beginning, you see I have a drums one. So if we look down here in our library, here's what they sound like alone. Then it plays for three measures and that comes into the bass riff two. So let's come down here and let's see, where's my bass riff two? Okay, so I can hear that. Let's go back to my mixer. Let's turn that up just a little bit here. Back to library. And if I scroll on down, you can kind of see the different parts. I have a guitar riff 2 coming in here, a little bit heavier rock, a rock guitar sound there. Scroll on back this way. I've got a bass break, so we have a little bit of a solo there, and then it comes up with a guitar solo here near the end, and I've got another guitar break, rhythm guitar coming in there, it looks like. And then finally, here at the end, I have a guitar phrase. And my drums, I have them fading out. Here's just another thing this program allows you to do. You can put in volume points, so I can turn the volume up on that drum track. In this case, I wanted the drums to fade out, so that's by pulling this down, you're lowering the volume. I don't want to have an abrupt drum ending as my guitar finishes up here at the end of the song. So you get the idea. It's multi-track editing. Each one of these tracks is a different instrument. You can play around, do the different combinations are really limitless, and you can have a lot of fun doing this. So once you're satisfied and have everything tweaked, I want to get in the habit of, I want to save that project since I just tweaked it just a little bit. And then when you're finished with everything, you can just simply go up to File, choose Mix Down, and I'm going to mix this down to an MP3 file. And let's call it, this is rock, say try one. So rock one is going to be my file name. Let's hit save, and whenever this saves, it will render all these tracks down into one MP3 file. It will open up the Surface Pro Music Player, and it's about a minute long, so we'll just let it play. You can see it rendering down here on the bottom. It takes just a second. Okay, so there you go. It's that easy to go out and do your own songs. Let's go back to the desktop here. And one of the nice things about doing this as a teacher or as a student is you're creating the music yourself, so you don't have to worry about the copyright issues and things. Mix that down to an MP3. This is what I use to throw in some of the music for our Tech Talk for Teachers podcast. And it's just a lot of fun. You're learning a lot about music theory and mixing things together. And if you happen to have a USB MIDI keyboard, it's a lot of fun to go out there and just freeform and create on your own. So until next time, this is Tom Grissom. Keep on learning.